Sub-basement?
I pushed ground. So did I.
Well, why didn't it open?
Looks like some sort of a club.
Never knew there was one in the building.
This elevator has no push buttons.
And there's no way out.
Someone's bound to come down here soon. Why not make the best of it?
Good idea.
Why not?
Let's do that.
Might as well, I suppose.
Thank you. Strange situation. Almost like a dream.
Dreams are much more frightening than this. At least mine are.
Really? In what way?
Strange. Mysterious. Unworldly. Almost unbelievable.
Yeah?
But so real. One feels sometimes that it's actually happening.
Why don't you tell us about it?
All right. I will.
Midnight Mess.
You're a stranger in town, aren't you?
Yes.
It's getting dark. You better get inside somewhere.
I'd like a menu, please.
I'm sorry, sir, but we're closing.
But it's dinner time. You can't close before 7 o'clock at night.
It's getting dark. We always close before dark.
They come out in the dark.
Who?
Who's there?
It's your brother. Harold. Yourself in a place like this. Why is everyone so afraid of the dark here?
Because of them.
Them?
There have been 17 cases so far. Bodies found with every drop of blood drained out of them. Now tell me why you wanted to find me so badly.
Father died 4 weeks ago. I've been looking for you ever since. You're his heir, you know. You always were his favorite. He left you everything. For as long as you live.
How would you like your roast tots? Well done, medium, rare.
Roast what?
Tots. Blood clots.
Two, please.
It's with me all the time.
Do you have a sister?
No. It's just a dream. We all have something like it. And you? What's your dream?
Why not his first? My what? Dream. Vision. Phobia. Obsession. Fear. Whatever you want to call it.
My dream is a very peculiar one. Very peculiar indeed. Surreal. Surreal.
The Neat Job.
Thank you. Thank you. Well, Wilson, as they say, congratulations are in order. I'm going to get married.
At your age?
Well, I spent a lot of time amassing a fortune, acquiring a lovely house, filling it full of beautiful things. Now I need somebody to look after them. And me, of course.
Who's the lucky girl?
Oh, nobody you'd know. The daughter of a chum of mine, Sir George Melch.
Little Ella, huh?
Well, she's not little now. She's grown up. Very charming, really.
But why on earth should she marry you?
I think so myself, somewhat of a catch, really. Very easy to get on with, actually. Eleanor? Eleanor? You've moved the furniture.
Yes, I thought it would look better if it...
But you've moved the furniture. I go for a magazine and it isn't there.
Darling, you must admit it looks nicer.
But you've moved the furniture. I'll never be able to find anything.
If it bothers you that much...
Well, of course... Of course it bothers me. Place for everything and everything in its place. That's how businesses are run. That's how society is run. And that is how a home should be run. Eleanor... puree, no spaghetti sauce, nothing.
I must have forgotten.
But there's no excuse to forget.
I came down to the nail.
You messed up my whole house. Can't you do anything neatly? Can't you? Can't you do anything neatly? Can't you do anything neatly? Can't you? Can't you do anything neatly? Can't you do anything neatly?
Are you neat and tidy?
Not more than anybody else. Yet.
Yet what?
So real.
I know the feeling. I've had it often with the...
What?
I tell you.
This trick will kill you.
And now, for a demonstration of supernatural power of human body. To withstand pain through the power of mind.
The real one is in his sleeve. No gods, no supernatural powers, no yoga. Just tricks. Huh? As a fellow magician, I can assure you of that. How much do you want for the trick? Name me your price.
There is no trick. The magic is in the rope.
The trick you showed me yesterday.
No trick.
Of course, the magic you showed me. I told my wife about it. And she wondered if you couldn't show it to her.
Oh!
before me a magic basket, blessed by the gods of the temple. I open it. Akbar, I give you my blessing. May the gods protect you from all danger.
You look as though you've seen a ghost.
There are no such things as ghosts, except in magicians' illusion.
I have a similar vision.
Do you?
Similar fear. Similar, but not quite.
Bargain in death.
It begins in a graveyard.
In a grave. A freshly dug grave. My grave. Buried alive. How did it happen?
A surefire plan, Alex. Now this will cut down my pulse and heartbeat, my entire metabolism, so that even the best doctor will think that I'm dead. Now these are pills I'd be taking if I had a heart condition, so it'll look as though I've had an attack.
There'll be no trouble getting a death certificate.
Now you must make absolutely sure that I'm buried not more than 24 hours after I die. Then all you have to do is wait until night, dig me up, and I'll hide at your place while you collect the insurance money, and we're off and away.
The perfect plan, except for one thing.
I'll never learn it. I'll never pass the anatomy course. Trouble is, we can only work in the dissection room for the short periods we're assigned to it.
If only we had a body of our own.
What?
Well, we could work on it when we wanted to.
Mr. Maitland?
Sorry if I gave you a fright. You got the money?
After we get the body.
What do you want his body for?
We're ghouls.
Did you hear a cough?
No.
No.
Oh.
You can give me the money now. It's all yours. Sorry about the head.
As if
you were going to do it.
But why that one? Why that particular nightmare?
Why are you interested in his nightmare? It's yours that you're really concerned with, isn't it?
Mine begins on an island, a tropical island, the island of Haiti.
Drawn and quartered.
Bob. Bob Dixon! Ah! What are you doing here?
I had some business in Port-au-Prince. I heard your name mentioned in a bar. How's the work going?
Not bad, I think. Self-portrait. But like all my work, scorned, considered worthless.
What do you mean worthless? I saw one sold only a few weeks ago for £5,000.
£5,000? Sold by whom?
Arthur Gaskell. In his gallery, he sold it on behalf of Lawrence Dilton.
But why such a price?
Your pictures. They've been highly praised by no less an art critic than Fenton Breedley.
Fenton Breedley? Fenton?
What do you wish?
To buy voodoo.
What do you do?
I'm an artist.
Put the hand you paint with. Into pot.
You cheated me. No. You cheated me. All three of you. And I'm going to have revenge.
Ha 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 ha
Benton Breedley, art critic, you saw my pictures and you lied about them to the public. Now, Mr. Art Critic, you will never see another picture again.
Tell you, she doesn't mean a thing to me.
How long have you been seeing her?
Look, darling, it doesn't mean I don't love you. You're my wife, but we're living in the 20th century now.
You'll never see another woman again.
Arthur Gaskell, art dealer. You lied to me. You told me that my pictures were worthless and that you couldn't handle them. You won't handle anything again.
You're doing it all wrong. Look. I don't know why we employ you. Now watch. Like that, see? Just use your intelligence. I'll show you once more.
Now, Mr. Diltant, you can wait until tomorrow. You have 2 minutes to live.
Don't move.
Just want to show you something. Thank you.
Collection complete. Thank you for watching.
That's your story. Well, we all have our cross to bear, haven't we?
But it seems so real. Almost as if it happened.
Happened.
Or could. You think that our fears could be a sort of warning? A warning of what may happen?
Nonsense.
That's how it is, and how it always will be. Night after night, we have to retell the evil things we did when we were alive. Night after night, for all eternity. Thank you.